Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for today. If you ask me which is one of highly customizable ROM along with better stability and performance, then I will recommend you Infinity X after Evolution X ROM. We already reviewed some of older version of this ROM along with last stable build 2.8. You will find its review given in Icard video. Infinity X recently started to roll out their new Infinity X version 2.9. which added some bug fixes and addition of some useful features, so all officially supported devices including OnePlus 12R will get this OT update. But if your device is not in the list, like old V2.8, we also brought you its GSI build, which should boot on any ARM64AB projectable supported devices. Today in this video we are reviewing this build on OnePlus 9T after installation of the GSI build. We will check out all the new changes done by team, and at the end I shown one of the major plus point of using Infinity X 2.9. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. We will first check out about device details of this update. This is the same treble TDGSI Android 15 build, but this GSI build is now officially released by Infinity X team. So all non-supported devices can also enjoy Infinity X on their devices. Maintainer of this official GSI build is Papaku. This update brings latest June 2025 security patches, except that kernel version will differ for different devices. Basically, new security patches is a major upgrade of this update. There are also additions of some useful features done by developers for this ROM. So let's check out them one by one. In Infinity X suite and under the navigation option for gesture navigation, team added new long back swipe gesture feature. This feature offers us lots of possibility to use different important shortcuts. Like, we can add different shortcut activities for long left swipe and long right swipe. Even we get new long left L swipe and right L swipe gesture. You can check here how you can activate your desired shortcut activity by using these types of gestures. This feature will definitely help to improve better multitasking of your device. But one setting I can't understand why it's added here, called as long left swipe application. Because we already get option in a shortcut to add desired application for long left swipe gesture, which acts same like this new option. Next is the old school feature, which was available for lots of old Android 12 to 14 custom ROMs, called as hide IME or keyboard space. When you access the keyboard for typing, there is a small space remains always there between navigation bar and keyboard, which will be removed or reduced by using narrow or hidden option available for this setting. Next, developer added new slider control setting to change size of clock available in the QS panel. Similar like QS panel clock, we get slider control to change size of status bar clock, which helps to highlight clock in a status bar. Even we get lots of new different styles for background chip of clock present in a status bar. Next, in the QS panel setting, team has added toggle to enable or disable Bluetooth dialog pop-up for QS panel type. If you disable this, now we will not get any Bluetooth dialog details of connected devices. Instead of that, you can directly disable or enable Bluetooth. Next, in the lock screen setting for custom clock styles of lock screen, we get this new toggle called as use ascent color for clock, which will apply ascent color of your system to lock screen clock. By default, this clock have white color. Also get this clock text opacity slider control, which will help to reduce or increase clock text opacity. Next, team has added music ticker notifications for always on display. But for me, always on display is buggy in the GSI, so I can't able to test this feature. Next, Infinity X team added ability to disable all user application including system apps. You will get this option in app setting. This is pretty useful to disable battery draining application which you didn't use frequently. Next, for all application who gets freeform multi-window shortcut in app drawer or on home screen, which will help you to open apps in a multi-window easily whenever you want. So these are all the changes and features added by Infinity X team. Along with this, there are lots of fixes has been done, which you will find in a changelog given in a video description. One thing I noticed in this update is that it's highly buttery smooth as compared to previous version. Even though I am using the JSA build, it's perfectly blended in my device and everything is just flying, like apps opening, closing, switching between applications, scrolling, animations, etc. This is all about for today, guys. If you specially looking for GSI that have lots of features and better performance, then you can go with this official GSI release of Infinity X team. And if your device have Infinity X custom ROM support, then you can enjoy this ROM without any bugs, while GSI may have bugs which may vary as per device you are using. That's it for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.